Okay, so it's delivery day and I got boxes in today. I wanted to talk just a few minutes about the free boxes that eBay gives us. I wanted to talk a few minutes about the free boxes that eBay gives us. Now, in all honesty, I can get these same boxes locally for about half the price any pretty much given day of the week. You can probably source around and look yourself, and you'll be able to find them cheaper. Now, the price that you used to pay for the stores used to be about half what it is now, and they said what they would do is they would raise the price and they would include all these boxes. So again, they're still pocketing some money from it. Good, bad, whatever you want to take from it, there's nothing you can do. It's been like this for a while. So I end up with boxes. We try certain ones. I do the poly bags, which these I actually use. These are pretty good. They're pretty comparable. Now, these are ones that I bought on their own, and they're pretty comparable. Sizes are a little different. It doesn't really matter, though, to me. So I don't mind using their bags. I just don't buy them, obviously, from my sources. So these I still use up, but I don't have to buy them. All the poly bags that they have, I've got multiple ones. I use the big giant ones. You can fit a ton of stuff in these as well. Any of the size of the poly bags I have, I think. And what I tried this time, I got $150 basically of these. And I was kind of surprised they were as big as they were. I think there's like, I don't know, 140 or something in one of these things. I've wrapped quite a few things and it's still a bunch. And I still have all these from the free boxes or free packing supplies that we get. If you're going to get them, get a store and you get the free supplies, at least use them. Don't, let them go to waste. If you don't use them by a certain date, they're no good. You can't take them back and, get any money or anything out of them. It's boxes or nothing, and it has to be done by the certain date that they expire on. It would be nice if they didn't make an expiration date on them, but that's what they're going to do. I also end up with tons of boxes. So we buy boxes from them. I get some new ones in here. One thing you can do with all of these, if you're not going to use them but you still get them, I'll sell them off to a local reseller that I know or something. And we know quite a few these days. So I've always got extra boxes. I know people that'll take these down to the flea market and get 50 cents a box for them all day long. People will come in, other sellers that set up there as well, and they may buy, half the booth or all the booth, and they'll just be done for the day. It just depends. If you know somebody, you can have them throw a stack out on a table or something as well too. They're not very hard to take out somewhere and stuff. Some of them are useful. I use these all the time, this size here. It's a 6x4x4. Never had any problem with them. The ones though, again, I get locally are usually better cardboard and they're cheaper. They're half the price. Most of these size are the majority of what they have these days. They used to have like 14-inch cubes. And I'm sure they cut them out because of the amount it costs to ship them. Everything went small. I mean, they got these in just recently, and these are for the record guys, I'm sure. No other reason I could see someone, throwing these out there. They're pretty good for cardboard for wrapping up paper, but it takes longer to cut this up than it does the boxes that I buy. So I'm just going to keep buying them. I mean, the ones that I buy, I can ship out 16 items for like 78 or 79 cents. So, take advantage of it though. It is free. At the end of the day, if you do have extras and stuff, you can sell these. You can list them on eBay, throw them in something. You'll get less than what they sell for on eBay, obviously, from the box one eBay supplies, the seller on there. But again, it's free money basically. Just sell them locally at a flea market or just call around to some of the other resellers, and ask them. You guys can swap out. So let's say you order one kind of thing, a whole bunch of, say, poly bags, and they order a whole bunch of boxes. You guys can switch half and half and stuff like that. It'll save you some time and money. And far too few people sit there and talk to other resellers in their area, and they don't have these opportunities. So it's honestly good to sit there and discuss things and, have conversation with local guys, because again, some of this is going to be swapped out for something else. So we've been selling off our extra cardboard forever. Again, so when a new batch comes in, I see how much we have left. of everything that we got, and then we'll write down what we order for the next lot, and then anything extra goes out the window. We'll sell it, and it'll be out the door. So, you know, it is free. I would rather just have the fees drop down in half, bring them back down to the $150, get rid of the box junk again, because I can get them locally for much cheaper, and I don't have to worry about them showing up or being here, or them bagging them up and leaving them out on my porches, which is what they usually do, or outside of your garage at your business or something. They just dump them off. They don't really take the time to, you know, even check if you're there. So if it's raining and stuff, they just bag them and leave them outside. They get wet. Oh, well, they were delivered and your boxes are SOL. So it just depends. If you have them delivered and you're always there, you know, you might be okay. But again, the supplies do very well. You know, they're bundled in hundreds. I think these are here. These are the bags I use for mailing out pretty much everything. These are the 6x9s, I believe, or 6.5 by 9.5, somewhere in that range. I don't get padded at all. I never, ever get the padded. Everything that I ship out goes with cardboard wrapped around it, so I don't need the padding. And some items with, you know, the cardboad that I wrap up, I don't put it in a bag. I don't need to. It can just be sent with thick cardboard on the outside, and then I don't have to worry about it. I think there was some other sizes that we ordered, too. Yeah, I have, like, every size that eBay does, we've ordered from them, other than, you know, none of the padding ones. These I probably use the second most, and I wish they had the size on every one of these, but this is, like, probably 9.5 by maybe 12 or somewhere in that range. This one I use for better comic books if they're going to be wrapped in stiff cardboard as well, or some magazines will fit in here. And then there's a, what's the other one? 10 by 12 or 12 by 14 is the other one, I think. And then this one here is one of the other sizes that we do order too. Now these are the massive ones here. I don't really use these very much though, in all honesty. I haven't ordered them again. I ordered two boxes of them, thought I would figure out some use for them, so I haven't, in all honesty. I usually end up folding them like that if I ever want to bag up like a sheet music that's wrapped in cardboard or something. It's just an extra layer of protection. Again, all the boxes are small, so if you do glassware and stuff, they're pretty darn good. This one here, I think, is the 8-inch cube. This one here is perfect for coffee mugs. This is the one I use for coffee mugs. And if you buy the tissue paper from them, it works great for wrapping them up. So you can just get a big wad of it. You can wrap them around a cup, and then you can stuff all the way around it, too. But that's what I use this stuff for, or I sell it, as I said. You can make an extra 75 or maybe 85 or so bucks back out of these supplies if you don't use them. And that's usually what we do every 3 months or so. Sometimes it's more than that. Sometimes I get close to, you know, fair market retail for it, which would be like the Walmart comparable price. The 75 cents for larger boxes down to, say, 50 cents or 48, 45 cents for some of those little tiny boxes you see right there, especially like these. But I usually keep all of these. These are perfect for, like, Marx figures, marbles, glasses, all kinds of stuff. Like these ones here I use for cylinder records specifically. These are perfect for that, 8x6x4. They fit in there perfectly. I've used these for cylinder records forever. Hopefully that gives you a little idea on what you can do with this and the usefulness of these. Again, you're stuck with them. At least get something that's going to be useful. If you can't use it, don't waste it. Get it and then sell the stuff and at least get a few bucks back out of it. That would be my recommendations. Most of the cardboard that we do get to actually ship, the majority of items, though, we buy brand new. Now, I get a lot of people saying, well, why do you buy it brand new when you can go out and source dumpsters or stores and stuff like that? I have to wait on all that stuff. I have to hope to get the exact same box size and everything else. And usually if they're like at a big store, they're only going to have like 4 or 5 of the same boxes. That's about all you usually put out on the floor at any time. And that's when they come out of the boxes. I mean, I've worked in stores, big stores and stuff, regional wise, store manager, even assistant. So I'm not going to sit there and try and source that. I need too much cardboard to piddle around, at least in my expense, because it's a lot of time when I do that. I can just go buy half a skid of cardboard, you know, 150 boxes all at once, 14 by 14s, and those can all be cut down into multiple sizes. And then I'll have the 12 inch cubes or the other one that Walmart carries, which are about the same comparable price, 78 cents down to like 44, 45 if you buy like half a skid or a pallet of them. If you know people too, you can go in and you can split a pallet of something. You know, you'll buy a big pallet, you'll get the discounted price, and then you can split it up, divvied up between you and several other resellers in your local area. Again, it comes back to talking to people and having some relationship and association with other resellers. It's a good plus for your business. So, you know, that's our shipping. That's why we get what we do and what we ship with. Everything that's paper-wise, the Victorian, goes shipped in new cardboard. For the main reason that it's all uniform. I always know I can get it. I always know what to do with it. I can cut it up all the same. It's easy. It's quick. Any other means takes more time. I have to try and source the exact same size of boxes because we send out hundreds and hundreds of the same size of items every single month, and I just have to have the same type of cardboard. It makes my life so much easier. I'm not, you know, against reusing boxes. I do that for some bigger items and stuff like that. Like the boxes that eBay sends the boxes in, I break those down and I'll use that cardboard to mail other things. The boxes, like these boxes come in another big eBay box. Those boxes, I use the cardboard to wrap up board games. It works perfect for board games, big toys that are still boxed up, and things like that. At least that's my experience. I enjoy wrapping them up. It's a challenge to wrap stuff to me. I don't mind wrapping up. It doesn't bother me at all. I crank up the music. I had Modern Day Cowboy by Tesla on this morning when I was doing it. Yesterday I had Dom, Primetime Treasure Hunters live show on. Dom's one of the channels that I do watch. He's a good friend of the channel. You know, so if you haven't checked out Primetime Treasure Hunter, check him out here on YouTube as well. Great channel. Most of the people that subscribe to me do subscribe to him as well. So anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this, though. This is just a touch on some of the shipping and what we do, the boxes, what to do with them, and the whole works. Hopefully that gave you some ideas and some thoughts. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that like button down below. You can also hit the bell icon to be notified if I post new content or go live. Subscribe and tell all your friends.
Pull his string, he walks 5 feet from romper room.